Welcome to the session on access to generative AI models as part of SAP BTP AI best practices. We will explore how to efficiently integrate generative AI models into business applications using SAP AI Core. By the end of this session, you will have a clear understanding of the principles, best practices, and implementation guidelines. Let's get started. Our discussion will follow these four key steps first. We will provide an overview of what accessing generative AI models entails and the benefits the best practice approach offers your organization. Second, we will cover the central prerequisites you will need to have in place before implementation, including both commercial and technical requirements. Third, we will explore the key choices and guidelines that will impact your implementation, including model selection and parameter settings that optimize performance for your specific use case. Finally, we will dive into implementation details across different programming models, providing you with concrete examples and resources for Python, JavaScript, TypeScript, applications, and Java. Interacting with generative AI models is straightforward, but requires a structured approach. The process involves sending requests that define the prompt, the model, and relevant parameters to generate responses. By leveraging SAP AI Core, we provide secure and efficient access to AI models, enable applications to harness AI diverse functionalities from automation to decision support. We will see how to optimize this process throughout the session. Why should you use BTP AI Core instead of accessing AI models directly? There are three main benefits. First, model interchangeability. You can easily switch between different AI models using the same code and implementation to best suit your specific task. You also get out-of-the-box features that supercharge your development with built-in capabilities like data masking, prompt templating, filtering, and variables. Third, security and SAP ecosystem integration. SAP AI Core is fully integrated into SAP's ecosystem, leveraging the best of SAP technologies for enterprise-grade security and compliance. These advantages make AI adoption more efficient and scalable. Before implementing, let's cover the prerequisites needed. You will need an SAP Business Technology Platform, or SAP BTP, subaccount, and an SAP AI Core service with the extended tier on SAP BTP, for which pricing information is available in the linked resources. To provide more context around these prerequisites, SAP BTP is an integrated set of cloud services, database, AI, and development tools that enable businesses to build, extend, and integrate SAP and non-SAP applications efficiently. SAP AI Core is a managed AI runtime that enables scalable execution of AI models and pipelines, integrating seamlessly with SAP applications and data on SAP BTP. It supports full lifecycle management of AI scenarios by setting up these prerequisites. You will establish a strong foundation for AI projects efficiently and at scale. Let's examine the high-level reference architecture for accessing generative AI models through SAP BTP. This diagram shows the complete flow from end users to foundational models. Starting from the left, we see end users and application clients connecting via HTTPS to the SAP BTP environment. Within the subaccount, the request first passes through an app router to an HTML5 app repository. The request then flows to a destination service, which directs it to the service containing the application service with the core application logic. Authentication and trust are handled through the auth and trust component. From there, another destination service forwards the request to the API hub, which is the central component of this architecture. The generative AI hub contains the SAP AI launchpad for management and monitoring. Second, SAP AI Core, which contains the critical functions, AI API for programmatic access, trust and control mechanisms for model access. The foundational model access components can connect to both partner-built and SAP-built models. SAP AI Core can then access both SAP-hosted foundational models within the platform and partner-hosted models like Azure AI through secure HTTPS connections. This architecture ensures secure control and efficient access to AI capabilities while maintaining integration with the broader SAP ecosystem. Let's discuss some key decisions that impact the performance and utility of your AI applications. Choosing the right AI model is a critical decision that impacts performance, accuracy, and operational cost. Important factors to consider include accuracy versus cost of a more complex model, typically provide better reasoning and context-aware, but come at a higher computational cost. Language support ensures that the model that you choose aligns with the languages and data structure relevant to your use case. Task complexity and specialization. Larger models generally excel in tasks requiring advanced reasoning, but some fine-tuned models may add performance to them in domain-specific applications, such as legal, financial, or technical text generation. Latency and scalability. Consider the expected request volume and response time. Some models are optimized for real-time interactions, while others perform better in batch processing scenarios. To make an informed decision, use the model library, which contains benchmark data. You can also find links to the list of available models and AI core endpoints in our resources. AI model performance is affected by parameter settings as well. In general, the default values already produce a great output result, but proper tuning can ensure a high-quality response tailored to your specific needs. Let's break down the key parameters for temperature, which controls the randomness of output. Low temperature settings are ideal for technical or legal writing where you need precise, deterministic output. High temperature settings work better for creative writing, producing more imaginative and random text for max tokens, which limits response length. Low settings are perfect for chatbot responses that need to be short and to the point. High settings are better suited for long-form contexts like detailed articles or stories. For presence penalty, which discourages reuse of any previous word. High settings are great for ideal brainstorming, promoting. Low settings work well for themed storytelling, reinforcing a central topic or character. For frequency penalty, which reduces repetition of frequent words. High settings are useful for summarization, reducing redundancy in data or articles. Low settings can be beneficial for poetry or mantras where repetition creates a stylistic effect. Understanding and fine-tuning these parameters will significantly enhance the quality of AI-generated content. Let's discuss implementation guidelines for selecting your programming model for back-end applications. We recommend using Python, which has a very well-maintained SDK and a robust ecosystem, or JavaScript or TypeScript, which offers strong type and the Node.js ecosystem for full-stack applications. We recommend using cloud-based application programming model, which is optimized for SAP integration, providing scalability, built-in best practices, and a seamless connection with subservices. For working in Java-based enterprise applications, there is a Java SDK to provide solid foundation for AI model interactions. Now let's explore the specific implementation options for each programming model. We've broken down the resources by language and programming model: Python, JavaScript, TypeScript, CAP, and Java. For Python developers, we recommend using the SAP Generative AI Hub SDK for building your applications. This SDK is specifically designed for leveraging generative AI models available in the AI Hub. Additionally, the SAP AI Core SDK and AI API SDK are valuable for managing the AI Core lifecycle for reference code. We provide you with an exact code sample that you can use to also check out the repository. For JavaScript and TypeScript developers, the SAP Cloud SDK for AI is the official SDK to use for reference code. We provide you with an exact code sample, but you can also check the excellent reference code in the SDK examples, specifically looking at the orchestration file, which shows how to perform chat completions. If you're building a CAP application, we recommend using the SAP Cloud SDK for AI. Through the CAP LLM plugin, we also provide valuable examples. The reference code is similar to the JavaScript and TypeScript example. We provide you with exact code example that you can also check the SDK examples focusing on the orchestration file. For Java developers, the SAP Cloud SDK for AI for Java is available for reference code. We provide you with an exact code sample that you can also check the sample Spring app example, which includes both server and controller implementations. For each programming model or language, we provide the recommended learning journeys that walk you through the implementation process. All these resources are linked, and we encourage you to explore them based upon your preference programming model. Each option is fully supported within the SAP ecosystem, providing secure and efficient access to generative AI models while maintaining the flexibility to choose the approach that best suits your team's skills and project requirements. Let's look at a practical example of how to implement an AI model using JavaScript. This code demonstrates the simplicity of using the orchestration client to interact with AI models. First, we create a new orchestration client with specific configurations. We define the language model to be used, in this case, GPT-4o, along with several important parameters, like max tokens is set to 1,000, which limits the length of the generated response. The temperature is set to 0.6, providing a balanced output between deterministic and creative responses. N is set to 1, indicating we want a single response next. We define the prompt using the templating approach, creating a simple user message asking what is the capital of France. We then execute the request using the chat method, which sends our configured request to the AI model through SAP AI Core. Finally, we get to have the results to the console using the getContent method. This straightforward implementation demonstrates how easily you can access powerful AI capabilities through SAP AI Core using just a few lines of code. This concludes our overview of accessing generative AI models using SAP AI Core. We covered the benefits of using BTP AI Core, architecture, prerequisites, implementation steps, the decision factors, and implementation guidelines with a practical code example. This best practice guide reflects the collective expertise of SAP specialists from across SAP, bringing you together insights to support your journey. Thank you for watching this session on accessing generative AI models. We hope the information provided helps you with a successful implementation of AI capabilities in your business applications.